Canto 15. True love that ever shows itself as clear in kindness, as loose appetite in wrong, silence that lyre harmonious and stilled, the sacred cords that are by heaven's right hand unwound and tightened, flow to righteous prayers, should they not hearken, to who to give will for praying in accordance thus were mute. He hath soothed good cause for endless grief, who for the love of thing that lasteth not, despoils himself forever of that love. As oft along the still and pure serene, at nightfall glides a sudden trail of fire, attracting with involuntary heed the eye to follow it erewhile at rest, and seems some star that shifted place in heaven, only that whence in kindless none is lost, and it is soon extinct thus from the horn that the dexter of cross extends down to its foot. One luminary ran from mid the cluster shone there, yet no gem dropped from its foil, and through the beamy like list flame in alabaster glowed its course. So forward stretched him, if of credence aught our greater muse may claim, the pious ghost of old Anchises in the Elysian bower, when he perceived his son. O thou my blood, O most exceeding grace divine, to whom, as now to thee, hath twice the heavenly gate been ere unclosed, so sparkled the light whence I turned me down to him, then unto my dame. My sight directed, and on either side amazement waited me, for in her eyes was lighted such a smile, I thought that mine had divided unto the bottom of my grace, and of my bliss in paradise, forthward to hearing and to sight grateful alike. The spirit to his prom added things, I understood not so profound he spake, yet not of choice, but through necessity, mysterious, for his high conception scared, beyond the mark of mortals, when the flight of holy transport had so spent its rage, that nearer to level of our thought, the speech descended, the first sounds I heard were, best he thou triunal deity, that has favor in my seed, vouchsafed, then followed, no unpleasant thirst, though long, which took me reading in the sacred book, whose leaves or white or dusky never change, thou hast allayed, my son, within this light, from whence my voice thou hearest, more thanks to her, who for such lofty mounting has with plumes begirthed thee. Thou dost deem thy thoughts to me from him transmitted, who is first of all, e'en as numbers ray from unity, and therefore dost not ask who I am, or why thee more joyous I appear than any other in this gladsome throng. The truth is as thou deem'st, for in this hue both less and greater in that mirror look, in which thy thoughts or ear thou thinkest are shown, but the love which keeps me wakeful ever, urging with sacred thirst of sweet desire, may be contented fully, let thy voice fearless and frank and jocund utter forth thy will distinctly, utter forth the wish whereto my ready answer stands decreed. I turned me to Beatrice, and she heard ere I had spoken, smiling an assent that to my will gave wings, and I began, to each among your tribe, what time ye keened the nature in whom not unequal dwells, wisdom and love were in one measure dealt, for that they are so equal in the sun, from whence ye drew your radiance and your heart, as makes all likeness scant, but will and means in mortals for the cause ye dwell discern. With unlike winds are fledged, a mortal I experience inequality like this, and therefore give no thanks but in the heart for thy paternal greeting. This, however, I pray thee, loving Topaz, that engemst this precious jewel, let me hear thy name. I am thy root, O leaf, whom to expect even hath pleased me. Thus the prompt reply, prefacing, needed added, he of whom the kindred appellation comes, and who these 100 years and more on its first ledge that circuited the mountain was my son, and thy great-grandsire, well befits his long endurance, should be shortened by thy deeds. Florence, within her ancient limit mark, which calls her still to matin prayers and noon, we chaste and sober and abode in peace. She had no armlets, no head tires then, no perfled dames, no zone that caught the eye more than the person did. Time was not yet when, at his daughter's birth, the sire grew pale, for fear the age and dowry should exceed, on each side just proportion. House was none void of its family, nor yet had come Hardanapolis to exhibit feats of chamber prowess. Montemalo, yet o'er our stubborn Tourette's rose, as much to be surpassed if fall as in its rising. I saw Bilicion Bertie walk abroad in leathern girdle and a clasp of bone, and with no artful coloring on her cheeks. His lady leave the glass, the sons I saw of Vichiu well content, with unrobbed jerkin and their good dames handling the spindle and the flax. Oh, happy they, it's sure of burial in their native land, and none left desolate a bed for France. One walked to tend the cradle, hushing it with winds and sound that lulled the parents' infancy. Another with her maidens drawing off the tresses from the distaff, lectured them old tales of Troy and Fiesole and Rome. A Saltereo and Shangeia, we had held as strange a marvel as ye would a Senanctus or Cornelia now, in such composed and seemly fellowship, such faithful and such fair equality, in so sweet household, Mary at my birth bestowed me, called on with loud cries, and in your old baptistry I was made, Christian at once, and Casaguida, as were my brethren Eliseo and Moronto. From Valdepado came to me my spouse, and hence thy surname grew. I followed then the Emperor Conrad, and his knighthood he did gird on me. In such good part he took my valiant service. After him I went to testify against that evil law, whose people, by the shepherd's fault, possess your right, usurping there that foul crew was released from the deceitful world, whose base affection many a spirit soils, and from the matridom came to this peace.